DeCantner, Violet Palmer, and Yvette McKinney. A great honor for those three to be officiating a national championship game.
Look for an up-tempo game, Mike. I think both teams are a little nervous. They're going to try and get the jitters out and get it up and down the floor as quickly as possible. We talked about both teams maybe starting out man-to-man, but we'll mix their defenses up.
Holtzclaw got the tip. Now she gets the ball back. Jump shot won't go. Passion Thompson had her hands on it, but here comes Panichero for ODU. And they take it away. Kyra Elzy has played great defense in the tournament. Then she got careless, and Panichero took it right back. Well, you said up-tempo. We've already had two steals in 19 seconds.
Kyra Panichero has not played against a defensive player like Kyra Elzy at 6'1 with her quickness and arms.
Steal by Jolly. She gets by Panichero. Holds court. 2-0 Lady Vols.
Old Dominion is a team that likes to transition, but Tennessee can steal the ball also.
Elzy out on Panichero, who led the nation in assists this year. That one's kicked by Thompson. They'll get a fresh 30 on the shot clock.
Stacy Himes, the senior, number 11 for Old Dominion, does not score a lot of points. She averages just 3. Kelly Jolly right now is cheating like crazy. Himes is on the weak side, and Jolly is coming over to double team, and she almost came up with another steal.
Himes, the weak offensive link. She will not shoot from outside either. She's only taken 36 three-point shots this year, and she's only hitting 23% of them.
Watching that out-of-bounds play and just the last couple possessions, watching the warm-ups, Old Dominion, who is number 2 in the country, the higher seed coming into this championship game in Tennessee, the defending national championship team from last year, they look like the looser team coming in. Old Dominion was a little tight in warm-ups.
Looked like Jolly was expecting a lot of contact, fired it up strong, missed everything, but knocked out of bounds out to Tennessee. Shot clock is at 19.
The Lady Monarchs had a wonderful game against Stanford as far as their aggressiveness, attacking. And that's why they're number 1 in the country in their defense. Tennessee has come out and attacked on their offense.
Very often teams that love to press don't like to be pressed in their time. Holtzclaw, very aggressive at the beginning of this game. Holtzclaw has all 4 of Tennessee's points.
And that's a great matchup with Mary Andrade on Holtzclaw. Andrade, a very physical player, and took Kim Starbert out of the game in the second half for Stanford.
I don't think anybody is going to take Sharequa Holtzclaw out of the game. Hines dribbled it off her knee. 4 turnovers in the first 126 for ODU.
Shamequa Holtzclaw, this is what she does best. If she doesn't spin, she just faces you right up and puts it in your face.
Wendy Larry has seen enough of this run. She takes a 20-second timeout, a minute 26 into the ballgame. Her team has been sloppy. They have fallen behind by 4. Tennessee, a team that was left for dead in the middle of the year, they have sailed through this tournament. Their closest game, believe it or not, was over number 1 and undefeated UConn when they beat them 91-81, and they have been bombing away from outside. ODU, on the other hand, has found the going quite tough. A pair of overtime games and a 2-pointer against Florida. But as they say, winning ugly is just fine. Winning by any other name, and they are here in the title match.
No question about it, and that's what they feel makes this team so good, is they have so much experience together.
Passion Thompson on the dish inside from Tiffany Johnson. So Tennessee going with their 2 biggest inside players at the start. And Abby Conklin will come off the bench.
Abby Conklin felt that she could help the team a lot better watching what was happening, setting things up off the bench. Tiffany Johnson and Passion Thompson, the inside players for Tennessee, have to match up aggressively against Old Dominion.
Look at Holtzclaw. 3 players around her. She manages to spin through. Elzy goes baseline. Can't get the shot. The rebound to Machinbuana.
Therese Machinbuana, we talked about how well she gets down the floor. They stop her at the high post, and she uses Passion Thompson. Slips right past her, much quicker than Passion Thompson.
Machinbuana at 6'5", very good. Panichero drops it to Himes.
You see, Himes does not look to shoot the ball.
Andrade, nice runner, used the glass. Mary Andrade from Lisbon, Portugal, has first two.
Andrade fouled out of that Stanford game, but she was the heart and soul to bring them back.
Holds court. Annie, we have not seen her this aggressive in the tournament. Normally, she lets the game come to her. She'll get her 20 anyway. Tonight, it looks like she can get 50.
No question. And obviously, she has a great supporting cast, but Pat Summitt has ridden on her shoulders all season long, and she's going with her in this tournament.
Knocked out of bounds off the foot of Panichero.
Panichero against Stanford only had two turnovers, but here we're going to see the ball handling of Shamiqua Holzklaw. Offensively, she is just taking Mary Andrade right to the basket and just pulling up for jumpers. And that's what makes her so tough to guard, because you can't let her go all the way.
Well, some wonderful numbers, but you know, the points could go all up if she wanted them to. And if they fit in the team concept, which they haven't yet. Knocked out of bounds to ODU. A turnover filled 3.5 minutes. And Wendy Larry's got to find a way to slow down Holzklaw, who has been eating a hole for ODU's defense so far.
Wendy Larry was sitting on the bench before the game with the national anthem and listening to her crowd and the whole crowd here, and she's just smiling. She's in the Final Four back in 85 when they won it as an assistant with Marianne Stanley.
Nia Butts checks into the ball game as she will give Elsie a break. Nice feed inside to Roberts, who uses the left hand and puts it down. Very quietly, Nyree Roberts has had a brilliant NCAA, over 15 points a game and 8 assists. And here's the double team. Almost got the steal.
What a great double team. And there's a grab by Andrade, knocking it away. But Tennessee comes back with it. Kelly Jolly kept backing up. Looked like two trains coming at her.
Jolly loses it again. Shot won't go. Natalie Diaz into the end quick, but she misses her first. Butts back the other way. Look at that speed. And then she missed the shot. Roberts to Machingrana. Well, the players are going to look forward to timeouts tonight. Nearly taken away from Machingrana by Thompson. Andrade. Rebound to Butts. Trying to go behind the back. She's fouled by Panichero.
Nia Butts coming into the game, knocks knees with Tisha Panichero. Made a difference.
First foul on Panichero. Tennessee by 2. National champion Tennessee with the early 2-point lead, Annie.
Shamiqua Holzklaw's grandmother, June Holzklaw, very instrumental in raising Shamiqua. And they are very close. As a matter of fact, when Shamiqua was younger and being raised by her grandmother, they would read the Bible in Psalms 23. And it's one of the reasons that Shamiqua wears number 23. And she has followed her from Iowa City in the regionals now to the finals.
More importantly, did she teach her to handle the ball? Jolly against pressure up to Holzklaw. Speaking of ball handling, what a performance. Missed his shot. Tie up on the rebound, and the possession arrow will give it back to Tennessee. Good battle between two strong players, Machingrana and Johnson.
And one of the reasons that Tennessee has gone with Johnson in the middle, very strong players, they have to step up their game. And Old Dominion, their players, Nyree Roberts, Thunder and Lightning, Machingrana and Roberts.
Andrade is a very tough defender. She reached in that time and caught her on the arm. One on Andrade. And they can't get her in foul trouble. She is the defensive stopper.
Mary Andrade and Nyree Roberts fouled out of the Stanford game. They
Andrade
are very strong players. Not a deep bench, but Mary Andrade was saying, look, you bench plays against us every day. You are a great bench, and you can come in the Stanford game.
Johnson in the corner picked up her dribble, gets it to Holzklaw. Nice pass to Thompson. She walked. 4 turnovers for Tennessee, and the pressure defensively getting to both ball clubs, forcing mistakes.
They are so quick, and not only their quickness, their aggressiveness. And with that aggressiveness, they can take you out of it and lose your patience as far as controlling the ball.
Diaz comes in to run the point, but a nice job she did using her body and leaning into the defense, but she missed the shot. And she's in the backcourt now with Panichero. Andrade will take the long jump. Elsie is back in, and she has a rebound. Elsie has been very important to Tennessee's run in this tournament.
Well, it's been a big game in that Notre Dame game, her career high 14 points, 9 rebounds, 5 steals, and 6 of 8 from the free throw line.
Jolly, nice dish inside. Passion Thompson has 4, and Tennessee hardly looks intimidated by the defense.
Passion Thompson only took 1 shot in her first game and had 1 rebound. She has played so well in the tournament for Tennessee.
And it's up to the guards to get her involved. Panatero, nice penetration as she can hit the shot. Diaz forces one from the baseline. Roberts got it.
That's obviously the shot that the Lady Monarchs want, is shots like that from Roberts inside. But right now, all the minutes, they are the ones that are forcing their offense, really trying to pressure themselves going into that defense of Tennessee.
They're getting some shots from people I don't think they want to have shots. Johnson turnaround jump shot. 2 for Tiffany Johnson, the junior from Charlotte, North Carolina.
And the Lady Vols coming down smiling back on defense.
Well, they... Diaz obviously giving Panatero a little breather here. Jolly knocks it away. She and Holzclaw waiting for the other one to pick it up. Andrade got away with a push. Holzclaw at the baseline. Double team missed the shot. This is going to be on Elsie. Andrade was very fortunate she didn't pick up her second person.
So, but it's cold in the Midwest.
Yes, it is.
Pat Summitt saying, don't rush, don't rush. Just pull things back. Don't be in a hurry.
Machinguana comes out high, and Thompson drops off of her back into the lane. Evelyn, who's got that great long-range shot, comes in. Her job is to shoot threes, but she missed that.
She usually comes in against a zone, but right now they're looking for some kind of offensive punch.
ODU only 4 out of 11, while Tennessee is shooting 50%. Jolly gets it back. She'll take the three. Long rebound to Roberts.
Both teams knew that rebounding was going to be very important in the last game. As we saw earlier, Tennessee was out-rebounded 40-24.
Another tie-up, fight for the ball, out of bounds, and knocked out by Tennessee.
And one of the reasons is the aggressiveness that Old Dominion attacks the glass. Wendy was saying earlier, Wendy Larry saying, we've got to eat glass. And we had made that statement the other night against Stanford. And she's got the players to do that. But also, Pat Summitt was saying in her locker room beforehand, big letters, rebound.
Abby Conklin checks in for the first time. She hits her starting. She says she'll kill you more if I come off the bench. And that's a travel.
Machinguana, you see her going to the glass. Nobody blocking her out. As a matter of fact, Roberts and Machinguana fighting over it. You've got to give credit as far as attacking the offensive boards. You have to see who you're going against.
Jolly gives it up to Conklin, who's an outstanding long-range shooter. She'll fire one and got it. Got a toe on the line. It's a 2. But she can come off the bench firing. Averages nearly 12 points a game. In the NCAA, it's 13.
Abby Conklin against Notre Dame was 3 of 4 from three-point range. Was really hitting the shots and then got in foul trouble. But coming off the bench, she was very poised on that shot.
Panatero, nice drive. And she threw it away. The three by Andrade. Roberts, blocked by Passion Thompson. That's her first.
The Lady Vols are trying to stay in the lane and force Old Dominion to take that outside shot. That time, Passion Thompson trying to force, put pressure on the outside, and it gets a foul.
And if they can force them to shoot the outside shot, it will be advantage Tennessee, the Vols by 6. Dominion trailing by 6 as we near the midway point of the first half. You've heard about the trade deficit. How about a trade surplus? Certainly is for ODU as they get Machinguana from Mozambique and Andrade and Panatero from Portugal.
One of the reasons Allison Green says it all, the assistant coach in her 6 years, an assistant for Wendy Larry. She played at Dartmouth, averaged 25 points, then played over in Portugal for one of the national leagues, and that's where she met everybody. As a matter of fact, Clarice Machinguana, her coach over in Mozambique, head coach in Portugal, and that's why she was able to go to Portugal.
Doesn't make a bad recruiting trip either. Andrade down the lane. And it's a travel on Holzclaw, says she was tripped. Well, Holzclaw had the fast start, really, offensively. She hasn't touched the ball lately.
You you got to give credit, though, because the Lady Vols are looking to spread the ball around, and exactly. You just can't key in on Postal.
ODU having a tough time getting the ball inbounds, having a tough time, as Annie pointed out, getting anybody inside because the Lady Vols jamming up the lane. Last 5 minutes and 40 seconds. ODU has really been in a scoring drought. They've hit only 1 of 11. That's 9%. And LaToya Small, number 30, has checked in. She's an excellent rebounder. Evelyn tried to get it inside to Roberts, picked off by Thompson.
Tennessee is just rotating wonderfully on their defense.
8 turnovers in 8.5 minutes for the Lady Monarchs. John, great steal by Panichero. That's 6 turnovers for Tennessee.
Well, one thing for Tennessee is they cannot force the ball to keep going inside when you've got triple team like that. The defense just sags great for ODU.
Early in the game, Holtzclaw was taking that shot. A lot of contact, no whistle. And there is an offensive foul, an elbow called on Elzy. That's number 2 on Kyra Elzy, and Pat Summit didn't like it.
Mary Andrade, we saw her in the Stanford game, get knocked in the chops. In that game, she stands on defense. We're going to see Panichero miss the ball, but Andrade, what she's so good at, after a defensive rebound by the other team, she stays down to harass, basically. Didn't do anything right there, and you see Elzy really come back on Andrade. And she shakes her head. Yes, I did. I got hit in the mouth.
Roberts kicks it away. It'll be out of bounds to Tennessee. In that semifinal game, Andrade nearly lost some real good natural teeth, and she was called for a foul on that play. Look at Holzclaw working inside against Andrade, often overlooked. Her defense, but we've seen her do the job the last couple of games against superstar scorers.
No question, and her defense not only gets overlooked, she is so, it almost makes her offense better because she concentrates better.
Baseline to Butts, got it. Some good-looking freshmen on this Tennessee team. And the lead, the biggest of the night so far, 16-8, Lady Vol.
And I tell you, they got some great freshmen coming in next year. They think Tennessee's going to be in the Final Four for the next 4 or 5 years.
ODU hurrying its passes, and Tennessee really hustling on defense. 10 turnovers against ODU. They can't keep it up at that pace. That would be 40 for the game.
They had 28 turnovers in the first mini. Their team that presses their offense as quickly as they can because of their defense, they are not taking care of the basketball right now in the sense of taking poor selection shots. They're being aggressive, but their decision-making is almost...
And I think Pat Summit would like to see the tempo slow down a little bit for Tennessee on offense because they're making some bad decisions as well. Panichero trying to create the contact. She does, but she can't get the bucket. Butts blows by Panichero. What speed! 4 for Nia Butts. An 8-0 run and a 10-point lead.
Nia Butts wasn't even highly recruited. She was at Pat's camp, and all the other kids said, hey, we wanted to come play with us.
Jolly with a steal ahead to Butts. Great catch and a great shot. Holy cow, what a rush by Tennessee. And Wendy Larry has just been hit with a technical. Is that correct? The official looked right at her after that play and blew the whistle.
Her assistant's trying to calm her down. Obviously not happy with the play of her team. Tennessee being the aggressor. You see Clarice Mashanguana getting the ball stolen and very frustrated. And I'm sure Wendy Larry is very frustrated also. Maybe it might get something to get her team going.
The T signal was for a timeout. My mistake. The way the official did it so emphatically, I thought it was a technical. Tennessee 20-8. Let's check in with Nancy Lieberman Klein.
Thanks, Mike. I was in Wendy Larry's huddle, and she's saying Tennessee is killing us on the rebounding war right now. We can't turn the ball over. We can't have brush screens. We've got to set solid picks against the man-to-man defense to shake ourselves free offensively. Mike?
Nancy, ODU last had a basket at the 14-14 mark, nearly 5 minutes. Panichero got her hands on it, nearly lost it back to Roberts. Back by Holtzclaw, but a
The thing that I like that the Lady Vols have done is come out and play man-to-man defense. We had talked earlier that they might switch up their defenses, play zone, because Old Dominion is not a good outside shooting team. But watch their defense. They just come in all over you, and they are not, don't look like they're switching right now because Old Dominion is very frustrated.
Roberts will go to the line. We remind you again, ODU not a good free throw shooting team, only 61% on the year, and they are really out of sync from the floor. They may need these free throws before they are done tonight. Roberts, a 54% shooter, she hits one of two. And now they can set up the press off the made bucket. And Kelly Jolly does him a favor and throws the ball out of bounds.
Well, she picked up her dribble in the backcourt, and she only had one player not even on her yet. You've got to keep your dribble until the defense gets to you, then you get rid of it before they're there.
Eblen comes back in. They'd love to get her on track from long range.
You see the high kicks that Old Dominion is sitting, but nobody's looking to shoot the ball from the outside.
Machinguana leads in. Offensive foul on Machinguana. That's her first.
Passion Thompson gets caught behind Machinguana. Good post up down low. And then, look at how far back Passion Thompson is. All Machinguana had to do was go straight up for the shot. But she had like a good 2 feet in between.
20-9, Tennessee.
Andy Larry's team going into a zone, trying to pack it in a little bit.
Thompson, who's out of the post in the corner. And there's the travel against Tennessee. Both teams having trouble with the opposite club's defense tonight.
And a good switch by the Lady Monarchs, switching their defenses. And you see the turnovers by both teams. Old Dominion only 2 points in the turnover category.
And that's really odd because they normally get so many points off mistakes. They run so well. And Panichero, who has had a tough opening 11 minutes, throws it away again.
And their floor leader is not running well. Just knocks Shamika Holzclaw down from behind, and nothing is called.
Boy, they missed that one.
Interesting topic.
Trying to inbound and stolen away by ODU. Himes with good defense picked it off.
And this is where Old Dominion has to capitalize on those turnovers and steals.
Himes working against Misty Green, who's coming for Tennessee. In and out on the jumper, offensive rebound to Machinguana.
Even though Himes misses a shot, a good offensive rebound, Machinguana and Roberts have to go to those offensive boards. But they can't go unless the shot doesn't go up.
Shamika Holzclaw has eight. Has she got the whole package or what?
I was talking to some coaches last night and I said, well, what do you think? They said, oh, the defense for Old Dominion is just so good. And another coach goes, Michael Jordan's playing.
Diaz down the lane and she threw it away.
Shamika Holzclaw's defense, look at her come to help out defensively. Tennessee just doubling up the dribbler. And Old Dominion is not picking it up. They're not getting rid of the basketball and finding the open player. And I tell you, wide open is Shamika Holzclaw on the layup after that steal.
And Andrade getting away with a grab after the steal, too. 15 turnovers in the first half for ODU. It's a remarkable statistic. Johnson picks up the dribble, needs some help, makes a bad pass. Somehow right to Kopp. When it goes your way, it goes your way.
Couldn't you get an assist on that?
I hope not. You can't bank it off the glass and hope to get on the stat board. 24-9, the biggest lead of the game, nearly another steal. ODU really out of sync. Roberts got the roll. They needed that.
Nyree Roberts has been very steady for Old Dominion. They need to get the ball in her hands a lot more. And there you see Tisha Panichero on the bench, and she's one player that can get the ball to her big players inside.
She's waiting at the scorer's table. Holzclaw with a beautiful pass. The Bucks can't hit the layup. What a pass by Holzclaw. three. Missed.
Diaz was big time in the game before against Stanford. She was 5 of 8. She is 0 for 3 coming into this game. We were saying in the beginning of the game that Old Dominion puts a lot of pressure on her, and they're aggressive. Look at Passion Thompson, or Tiffany Johnson, I should say, Bane, Clarissa Machinwana.
Both teams have avoided foul trouble so far. Kyra Elzey, the only one with more than a single person. Thompson in the corner, drive for three. Huge shot. First three for Wendy Jolly, who did not play in the first game and has keyed the late season run for the Lady Vols.
And in that first meeting, Old Dominion won by 11, but Tennessee was up by 10 points in the second half.
Panichero dumps it off to Martin Guan.
I think they're very lucky on that play right there. Panichero had the shot, but she almost took a little bit too extra time. And when the big pull for Tennessee came out, the timing was perfect to get the ball inside of Martin Guan.
If Martin Guan doesn't react beautifully, it's another turnover. Then Martin Guan on the steal. Was trying to get back, and she missed the shot. The foul will draw the foul.
Stacey Himes coming down, trying to screen off Abby Coughlin. Clarissa Machinwana does not finish the layup, but she does a good job as far as staying in bounds. Missy Green not taking care of the basketball. Machinwana, very quick hands, and as we've said all along, she is very fast and quick getting down the floor. Does not use her left hand going into the basket, uses the right misses, but as we said, enough presence to stay on the floor to get the offensive board.
Tiffany Johnson ends up getting the personal. The numbers on Machinwana for the season in the NCAA, right around those numbers, just slightly under both her scoring and rebounding average. She has been tough against Stanford, 18 points, 8 boards. She's hit 1 out of 2 from the line tonight. They need all of these they can get.
I mentioned that she is the lightning from Thunder and Lightning because of how fast she is. Ivy Roberts is the Thunder because of her strength. Of course, Tennessee, on the other hand, calls Shamiqua Holzclaw and Kyra Elzey their Thunder and Lightning.
Jolly beats the press. Good job by the point guard. Approaching the 5-minute mark. Holzclaw, jump shot, won't go. Machinwana with a rebound and can't get the break going.
Some great up-tempo by Tennessee. They have controlled it with their defense and also their rebounding. Old Dominion trying to slow things down.
Andrade trying to get by Holzclaw. Beautiful lean-in by Andrade, and she has 4.
What a pretty play by Mary Andrade. Just a little pump fake and goes right underneath Holzclaw.
27-17. This is the way ODU came back against Stanford. Down by 15 early and made a big run. Thompson, nice pass. 6 for Passion Thompson, the lead back to 12. Boy, this has been a good game so far.
Been up and down.
Hines against Jolly. Andrade wants the ball. She's being guarded by Brene Laxton, who's in for the first time. They get it into Roberts. She missed it badly. Really rushed that and expected more pressure. Pat Summitt talking to Jolly. In her 10th NCAA Final Four in 16 years. What an incredible record. Holzclaw, 4-step run. Good play by Panichero. She's got Hines wide open. And didn't see her down court. Panichero will rarely miss an opportunity like that.
Machinwana had the shot, but she put her face right looking down at the floor.
Roberts penetrates against 3 Tennessee players and scores. Roberts with 9.
Does a nice job splitting the defense and avoiding the charge.
Jolly looks to Pat Summitt again. What play she wants. Calls it out. Andrade, nice reach-in defense against Holzclaw and knock it off the All-American's foot. Timeout on the court. Only 3:12 to go first half. The defending national champions up by 10.
See with the 10-point lead, 29-19 over Old Dominion. We told you we would spotlight Clarissa Machinwana, see what she does with her great footwork. Check this. miss out on
Marianne
the Drotty
was saying, look at
you.
You
get a chance to see her heels defensively against Tiffany Johnson. See how she moves her feet, knees are bent, trying to trap, and see how she can recover and help. And then on the offensive end, the footwork, she's able to work a little give and go right there with Panichero. Footwork like that will help her when she gets the ball. You see 20 touches, not a lot of results, but Clarice Machiguana seems to be warming up somewhat for Old Dominion. Mike?
Nancy, they're going to need a lot more from her, too. Down by 10 points, ODU with the basketball. Exactly 3 minutes to go. Amber Eller, number four, is in Wendy Larry's lineup.
Tennessee has dropped into that zone.
There's the outside shooting that they can't connect on Aubrey Emmel, who was nearly a 40% long-range shooter, has struggled here since we have reached Cincinnati. One of six against Stanford. She can't buy one tonight either.
And a good move by Tennessee coming out of that timeout, going into the halftime in that zone.
Conklin to Laxton. Laxton fighting with the ball. She nearly turns it over. Now
Summit has won four NCAA titles. Old Dominion has one NCAA title, but two AIW titles. We've got three national championships.
ODU shooting only 32% tonight. Tennessee nearly 60. Post ball, going to work on Andrade. Lost the ball, got it back. Shot clock went off.
Well, they counted it.
The shot clock went off before that ball came out of her hand.
No question about it. And there's blood on Passion Thompson's knee. D. Canter calls a timeout. Wendy Larry is now finally saying, hey, come here.
That ball was not out of Shamiqua Holdsclaw's hand before zero hit and before the buzzer went off.
But I think she's got to argue the call as soon as it's going off. I think she was stunned that the officials didn't call anything. We don't see the 30-second shot clock. There it is down in the corner, and you can tell the ball is still in her hands.
Now you can listen to it for the horn.
She was just going up in the air.
That's a second and a half before she let go of the shot. This is, as I understand it, a correctable error. The first dead ball after the error, you can correct it.
This is what the officials are talking about. You have an official on the sideline also.
Decanter, Violet Palmer, and Yvette McKinney, outstanding officiating crew. And that was an obvious call if they can get some help from the scorer's table.
Score stands at 31-19 right now.
That would cut it back to 10. Of course, Pat Summit and...
And they count it.
Oh. Boy, that's a tough call. Andy, when you have a chance to go back and consult about it and then still get it wrong, that's a shame.
No question about it.
I am told now they are saying it is not a correctable error. It does not fall under that category in the rules, so they are not going to change it.
Well, the biggest thing for Old Dominion, too, Mike, they've got to get going here on offense. They can't let something like that bother them.
The ODU guards have still not scored in this game. A minute 47 to go in the half, and Panichero keeps them at zero with another miss. 31-19 Tennessee. ODU, the most proficient scoring team in the country. They've been held to 19 points in 18 and a half minutes.
Shoot rainbows like that over Karen Rogers of Connecticut. The bigger the defensive player coming out at her, the higher she shoots it.
She is 2 for 2 off the bench, 6 points.
And Shaka Stevens in the game for the Lady Vols. She's just banging the players inside for Old Dominion.
Machiguana, a lot of contact, no whistle. Tennessee basketball under a minute to go.
Old Dominion is penetrating too deep. What they need to do is just pull up for little 5- and 8-foot jump shots.
And Tennessee is doing a real good job of keeping its position. position, not stepping in front of anybody, and the officials are letting them play.
Because the interior offensive players for Old Dominion like to go all the way to the basket, and the defense is sagging in for Tennessee.
Shot clock is down to five. Jolly had to force it inside, taken away. Good defense by ODU. They'll get another chance before the half, and they need it down by 15. A whistle and a foul inside, and that's going to be on LaShonda Stevens as she picks up the personal. That's her first. That's only the fifth team foul against Tennessee, or make it the sixth team foul against Tennessee, so we're not in the bonus yet.
Clarice Mashinguana really working hard inside, and Old Dominion wants to go inside to her. You see Stevens just kind of banging her a little bit and picking up the foul, but Mashinguana has really worked hard in this first half.
Nice move by both coaches to get a couple of their stars out with only 15.9 seconds to go in the first half so that they won't pick up a cheap foul. Panichero to inbound. Boy, Old Dominion needs a bucket in the worst way to take into the locker room. The difference in this game in their win in the first meeting, 25 points, 9 assists for Tisha Panichero. Tonight, she has yet to score and only has 2 assists.
And also coming off a big game against Stanford where she had 18 points, 6 assists and only 2 turnovers, also 5 rebounds. She was so focused in that game. She does not have it tonight. We talked about her wrist is maybe about 85-90% what she hurt in the Purdue game. She didn't bother in the Stanford game though.
And they don't get it in 5 seconds. A turnover by Panichero. ODU can't do it. And Pat Summitt racing up and down her bench. She wants shooters in there for the final 15-9.
The table has been turned on Old Dominion against Stanford. Stanford could not get the ball in against the defense that Old Dominion did. And this is where Pat Summitt and her staff, Al Brown, Holly Warlick, and Mickey DeMoss, are so good at out-of-bounds playing and defending against the opponent.
They've got to hurry. Johnson, dangerous pass to Conklin. Conklin stolen by Panichero. Mashinguana picks it up. What a huge lift for ODU at the buzzer. A heave from 10 feet right of the circle. Bingo. 34-22. They cut the lead from 15 to 12.
Great hustle by Old Dominion. Panichero steals the ball, which we've seen her done an awful lot from behind, and Evelyn just throws it up there, and a bank shot cutting, as you said, the 15-point lead to 12, and this is going to give the Lady Monarchs great momentum going into halftime. We'll see emotionally whether that big basket will lift the Lady Monarchs in the second half.
This is Hines guarded by Jolly. Andrade dumps it down to Mashinguana. Carson Thompson got away with a push. Holstall, nice decision to hold it up.
Lady Monarchs have done a tremendous job controlling the tempo of the game, and with Old Dominion missing a lot of shots, they're trying to force things not within the tempo of their game.
Holstall switches to the left hand, goes left and buries the jump shot. Andrade overplaying her to the right, and Holstall says, I can go the other way.
And Nyree Roberts steps out at 6'3 to help out, and Holstall says, oh, not calling up.
Holstall just wonderfully consistent. Panichero to Andrade. She tries to work it inside. Terrible pass by Andrade. Panichero has it back. Jump stop in the lane hits. Her first 2 points of the night, Tisha Panichero.
And Kelly Jolly still helping out on defense. Old Dominion really has to recognize that she is just cheating. Stacey Hines is the one that has to call for the ball and start shooting.
One of the reasons they brought Evelyn in the
game. Oh, nice pass.
Johnson couldn't hold it and stolen by Panichero. Her chance for an easy bucket, and Panichero right down the gut. Got it. 4 points in 20 seconds for Tisha Panichero. The lead back to 10.
A very nice 3-on-2 break for Old Dominion. They just took their time. They did not rush it.
Keep in mind, they were behind 15 to Stanford in the semifinals and came back to win. They were behind to Tennessee 10 points in the first meeting and came back to win. Bears have.
We talked about the beginning of the game and warm-ups at ODU looked a little tense, but they look a little bit more relaxed coming out. You have to remember that Tennessee is the defending national champion. They have been, in the last 3 years, in the finals.
Loose ball out of bounds to ODU. Here's Nancy.
One of the adjustments Wendy Larry said at halftime is that Tish Panichero has to relax and control the team. They must have spacing against the Tennessee defense and establish the high post to relieve some of the defensive pressure. Defensively, they feel they need to bring themselves in the circle more and help out on the post players down low against Tennessee. Mike.
All right, Nancy, and they've got Eblen back at the ball game. Remember, she hit that remarkable three just before the end of the half. Panichero trying to penetrate against LG. Got it to Martin Guana. Nice job by Panichero. Different player in the second half.
Very much under control that time. Didn't leap up into the air. Stayed on the ground. And look at Martin Guana rolling to the basket when the defense stepped up to help out.
Panichero may have overextended herself on defense that time. Picks up a slap, her second foul. Excuse me, they're going to give it to Andrade. That is her second, not Panichero.
You see Passion Thompson released from Mashinguana to help out. And nice dish because the defense is too slow for Johnson to rotate.
Andrade, two on one with Panichero. Nice dish. Tipped out of bounds by Tennessee.
We saw the other night Kate Starwood have a tremendous first half. Second half, nothing would fall for her. Nothing would fall for a lot of the Stanford players. And for, there's Kate Starwood, the player of the year in women's college basketball, sitting here watching this game. But Tisha Panichero not able to finish that layup.
And you know Kate Starwood did not want to be here in Civvies. Panichero's done a much nicer job against LG in the second half. That time she lost it, but it was last touch by Tennessee.
She was a lot more under control in this half. Even though the ball goes out of bounds, they still get it. But she is the one being aggressive and just is making better decisions because her teammates, as Nancy was saying, they're spacing it better, so the defense is not able to help out as much. She's looking to pass or she can go up for the shot.
And Park Summit, recognizing the problems that Elsie is having, has Nia Butts come in on defense. And Butts got a hand on the inbounds pass and picked off by Tennessee. The 18th turnover for ODU. Well, Johnson and Machinwana really banging inside, and Jolly throws the ball past Nia Butts, who says, that was my fault. 19 turnovers for Tennessee.
We saw early in the first half all the banging that was going on. Tiffany Johnson on offense and Machinwana trying to front. Tiffany Johnson rolling. Just bodies are banging this whole game.
Panichero with a great drive back to the baseline and scores. She has six all in the second half. It's an 8-point lead. Here come the Lady Monarchs.
Wendy Larry talked about hopefully that her team would have the legs because they played a tough game against Stanford.
Bucks with a great first step. Missed the shot. Coach call with a rebound. Eblen nearly stole it.
Monarchs have gotten the jitters coming out at halftime. They've gotten rid of it.
Absolutely. Jolly goes baseline. Cut off, she's double teamed. It's a tough place to go. Dangerous pass across the lane and picked up.
Well, you can't go above those trees. You got to try and split it. And Kelly Jolly unable to do it.
Panichero with great ball control. Might have carried that one a little bit. Got it into Roberts. Roberts has 11. Lead's been cut to 6. Pat Summit needs a timeout, and she's going to take one.
There's no question that Pat Summit knows that this is the type of team, especially what they did against Stanford, coming back, going into overtime. They are very capable of coming back. They play with so much heart, and they will leave it on this floor. Tennessee has to be very careful that Old Dominion does not start controlling the tempo of this game.
Take a look at that last play with Panichero. Watch the way she handles the ball.
This one, she almost looked like she got out of control. She's up. I thought she came down before she passed the ball, but she gets rid of it. They score the 2 points. Tennessee trying to help out, and Panichero being very aware where the defense is and much more under control in this second half.
Roberts with a big bucket inside. biggest comeback in Final Four history against Stanford. They were down by as many as 16 in this game. Holtz Club, that's the answer on offense. Holtz Club has 14. Whenever you need a bucket, you find the All-American and she'll get it. And now she's out on Panagera. Machingrana using the body to get some space. She has 10. Smart play.
Mimi Griffin had mentioned earlier in the game that Pat Summitt had to figure out a way to stop those post players of Old Dominion getting the ball inside, and they've done a pretty good job.
Elsie with that tremendous speed, but the shot won't go for it. Holtz Club battles for it and it's off of ODU. Andrade shaking her head. She thought Holtz Club was over the back. 15:09 to go in the ball game for the national championship. 15:09 left in the championship game. Tennessee has seen its lead cut to 6 at 40-34. Tennessee, of course, a fixture with its third straight title game. ODU back for the first time since 85. And Shamiqua Holtzclaw working to become the leading scorer in the 1997 tournament, only 6 points behind Katrina Gaither, who had a great tournament for Notre Dame.
And Bridget Gordon of Tennessee holds the scoring record in NCAA tournament history.
Inbounds to Holtz Club against Panagera. Cotton is back in with a good outside shot. Dangerous pass picked off by Panagera. Can they cut it more? Panagera all the way, missed the shot.
I don't care if she misses it, that was a sweet move.
Yes, it was. She's got it outside, trying to blow by Elsie. This is a three by Andrade, not her specialty. And we'll go the other way for a foul on Small.
Andrade only about 35% from three-point range, 29-83 coming into this game. But she's wide open, and that's what Tennessee wants. So they go ahead. Old Dominion sends in Aubrey Evelyn, who hit that shot going into halftime. Her team calls her the Mad Bomber. And the reason he is because she can score from the outside.
Check at that last foul on Cotton, and ODU retains possession of the basketball. Down by 6.
You know, Passion Thompson is doing such a good job defensively. When you see Machingrana going down to the floor, Thompson is making contact high away from the block, and then she's backing off. Machingrana, great footwork. She's trying to get low. There's the body. It was Passion Thompson. She pushes off there, but she's stepping away. Machingrana, we've seen her a couple times fall down.
Evelyn for three. Roberts trying to clip it alive, but Elsie hustles into the corner, and she is fouled. That's two on Panagera.
That's a big possession right there, because if they get two, they're only down by 4. They tried really hard to get the offensive boards. Tennessee hitting the glass.
What if Evelyn hits that three out of the corner? That would cut the lead in half. This place would really go crazy. Tennessee still shooting 61%. And right now they need to get a ball to hold score. Blocking foul as Thompson goes to the basket.
Mary Andrade is trying to come over and help on defense. Is a little late getting there. She's a player that takes a lot of charges for this Old Dominion team. And you see Passion Thompson in the middle, Andrade down on the wing, out of the wing, guarding the Holtz spot, and then she comes over just a little bit too late. Thompson already made the move inside.
This will be the first free throw of the night for Tennessee as Andrade picked up her third. And Passion Thompson is a 77.7% shooter, misses the first.
Passion Thompson really struggled in December. Her grandmother was in the hospital, which she has gone into the hospital again tonight. And her mother, Ruby Jean, is here tonight. But in order to keep her grandmother's spirits up, they put pictures and articles in the hospital so she would stay well. And Passion Thompson missed the Texas game and went back home for it to see her grandmother. And there you see her mom hiding down behind the fans, sitting down with the glasses on, Ruby Jean, and saying a few prayers for her daughter and for her mother.
And our thoughts go out to them as well. Another turnover, 19 for ODU. Tennessee has committed 20, make it 21 now. Jolly brings it up, goes to Elsie.
Old Dominion in that zone.
This where Holzkopf can find some space if they can find her. Good double team by the zone. Holzkopf trying to run the baseline, knocked away, stolen again. Panichello ahead, Coughlin back. Missed the running hook.
Not a bad shot, but you think a one-on-one situation, you go right at the defense and create a foul instead. She went away from the basket. A wonderful opportunity missed for Old Dominion.
Holzkopf at the back of the rim. Goes for the steal, doesn't get it. Martin Dwyer gives it up to Panichello. 13-11 and counting. A 6-point lead. We've been stuck on 40-34 for quite a while. Small, who's an excellent rebound at 5-11. Martin Dwyer, the pass too high from Andrade.
A little impatient on the offense, 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Andrade trying to make things happen. It looked like they were standing around a little bit, but you could see Mashaguana a little too tired to go up and get that ball. Again, you see the bending down low. Great shots as far as watching the inside play, but just cannot get enough lift to go get the ball.
Amber Eller comes back in. She's number 4 for ODU. And Misty Green checks in for Tennessee, along with Tiffany Johnson. Now 20 turnovers on ODU, and the defense has really forced both clubs to throw away.
Matchup zone for ODU, and then Tennessee has 3 good outside shooters.
Coughlin has hit 3 threes, and you just knew when she got behind that screen, the ball was in.
No question. You put Abby Coughlin, Misty Green, and Kelly Jolly on the outside of that zone, and somebody's going to knock it down.
43-34, a huge bucket for Tennessee as they had the lead go to 6. And here's the foul on Martin Dwyer, and that would be her second as she battled to get the offensive rebound.
And ODU, a very emotional team. They've got to get together. They're kind of hanging their heads a little bit. And you've got to look at the Portuguese connection. They've played together so well. Nyree Roberts also in there. And they've got to pump it up again and get their emotions going, because that's the kind of team they play.
And even though this team is 34-1, they are fighting for respect. They don't feel they've gotten the credit they deserve all year long. There's a holding foul away from the ball.
Mary Andrade picking up another foul.
That is 4 on the junior from Lisbon, Portugal, their best defender, an emotional player for them, and a team leader. Big foul with 11:59 left. ODU cut the lead to 6. Tennessee has increased it to 9 with 11:59 to go in the ball game. And we talk about the supporting cast of Tennessee. Other people other than Holzkopf has to step up. Against Oregon, it was Coughlin. Against Colorado, Passion Thompson came through. Kelly Jolly against UConn with 19 points. And in the semifinals against Notre Dame, Kyra Elzey, 14-9-5. Tonight, Coughlin has come through with 10 points. She has hit 2 threes, a pair of normal buckets, has 10 points on the night. Holzkopf spins into the lane, couldn't get it. Fight for the rebound belongs to Panichello.
And right now the seniors for Tennessee, Passion Thompson and Abby Coughlin, have stepped up. We talked about Tamika Holzkopf carrying this team on her back, but as you said, she's got a great supporting cast, and it's not just her.
And you always look to the seniors. Roberts held up by Coughlin, saved by Eller. Shot clock at 7. Panichello, nice crossover dribble to get free. She'll draw the foul. Pretty play by Panichello.
Panichello a lot quicker than Misty Green, and hopefully you hope back line will help you out defensively. Panichello creates the foul with that leaner and going to the free throw line.
Panichello only a 64% free throw shooting shooter on a not a good free throw shooting team.
As you said, she uses her left hand so well. She leaves the ground and goes right into Abby Coughlin. Panichello is one of the few big guards around the country at 5'11". About 4 years ago, there was a kid out of Cal, Milica Vukadinovic, at about 6'6", and she could do everything. and she's from Yugoslavia. And the kids from overseas, when they're that size and can handle the ball so well and shoot and penetrate, they are great to watch.
43-36, Conklin, nice job breaking the press, gets it to Green. Osquan not getting as much rest tonight as she had throughout the tournament. I'm sure Pat Summit realizes, you know, you can rest after this all summer. Kelly Jolly. Nice clear out by Panichero to create space underneath in ODU basketball. Jolly trying to check Panichero. No one's having any luck in the second half.
Good quick passes by ODU. Nice cut down, but Aldemir also had some outside shots. They don't have the shooters, but a great pass and inside cut by Panichero and Mashaguar working together as they have on the Portuguese club team that they play on overseas.
Mashaguar, a little running hook. The lead is only five. Holdsquare doesn't get the roll, fights for the rebound, picks up a foul. That's two on Shamiqua Holdsquare.
Mary Andrade going to the corner, does it all, not only from the top, but the corner. You see Mashaguana switching up top. Nice pass down the court. And the quick feet, always under control, good balance. Tiffany Johnson not able to pick her up, but Holdsquare, is she doing too much? I don't think so. We've seen her do this so many times and come through with big buckets. But she comes up with the foul right now because Old Dominion is pressuring Tennessee a little bit more.
Counting down toward the 10-minute mark. The Leafs can cut to five. Mashaguana travel.
That's a great step by Clarice Mashaguana going to the basket. I like that because Tennessee was sagging back, and she just split the defense.
Hey, the first two were pretty good. It was the third one. 22 turnovers apiece. Tennessee becoming very careless.
Amber Eller came into the game against Stanford and came up with some big steals. Just aggressive defense against Jamila Ryman as she's doing against Kelly Jolly.
Eller's a dangerous pass as Mashaguana is up there at 6'5". Jolly with penetration. Mashaguana lost it, but picked up by Eller. Panichero, great defense by Holdsquare. And then she turns it over. And a Tennessee player is down, Abby Conklin.
She has a broken toe. She did it earlier in the season. She was holding her foot. She broke her finger earlier in the year. She also has a broken toe. You see her going to the basket. And you see the ankle go down on Nyree Roberts' foot. So it's not the toe, it's the ankle.
Well, it may also be the toe because it's the little toe on the left foot and all the pressure ends up down there. She broke it in January, re-injured it at the beginning of this month.
On a couch. And she's played well, so she's had the broken toe.
Not able to put much weight on that left leg as she walks off the court. They ice it down all the time she's on the bench. And Lori Milligan, what a return this is. A young lady who had knee surgery in February, back on the bench. She would only be available if there is a technical situation. A la Kentucky, she would be able to go in and shoot technicals.
And Jenny Moshak, you see the trainer there in the blue print, has really had a MASH unit all year long. There has been an injury to one player or another all season long, and Pat Summit has had 14 different lineups because of all the injuries.
ODU has not been this close since it was 10-8. Evelyn has spun out on her. Offensive rebound for the Lady Monarchs. Andrade, cross court, Evelyn will try it again. And she did what shooters do. So they're not going in fine. Give me the ball back and I'll try it again.
The Mad Bomber comes through again. She has had a career high against UNC Wilmington. 8 of 12 three-pointers. She can knock them down. And boy, is that a lift for the Lady Monarchs. And a tough pass by Mary Andrade, Kelly Jolly knocking her down, but also Emblin does a good job just kind of throwing her arms out and says yes. A great quick release. There's the emotion of this Old Dominion team, and it is led by Mary Andrade.
Emblin, a chance to take the lead. She's their best free throw shooter. The first time tonight, Old Dominion has had the lead with 9:06 to go in the game. They have come from 16 down to do it.
They have switched things up defensively against this Tennessee team. They look rattled in the second half. They are the ones rushed and turning the ball over.
Mystic Green had Holtzclaw open momentarily. Tennessee looks a little shaken right now. Johnson gets it low. Nice answer. Good pass by Elsie. Tennessee regains the lead.
It's amazing what patience can do. They're looking to see Holtzclaw come out to the middle, come out to the wing, and the defense went with her, making Tiffany Johnson wide up in the side.
Petra working against Elsie. She's done very, very well in the second half. ODU regains the lead on Amber Eller's 15-footer.
Eller only averages 3 points a game in only about 11 minutes. Emily has not played that much in the tournament, but she, when she's played, has come through with some clutch situations.
Misty Green leans into one and missed. Andrade is tied up with Thompson, who will get the foul.
They call it on Mary Andrade. That is her fifth.
Mary Andrade is gone. They had their arms locked.
She cannot afford to get a technical.
And she is just crushed.
She's trying to get her team together, but the emotional leader on this team fouled out in the Stanford game.
And Thompson were locked up.
You see the arms. Watch her right behind. Thompson just grabbing her around the neck. And they see Mary Andrade with her arms around Passion Thompson's arm, but she threw them back up and thought for sure it was going to be on Passion Thompson.
Well, that's a tough call on Andrade.
No question about it. She had the arm right up in her neck.
Elsie goes baseline and hits it. A seesaw battle. The first two for Kyler Elsie. Cheryl has taken over control of this game. Emblin for three, got her on a rebound. Leaned into one, knocked the shot. But they would have led in that situation. Panichero, another steal at the other end. Emblin. Not bashful, is it? Offensive rebound. Amber Eller keeps it alive for ODU.
Wendy Larry said, okay, let's set it up, because they are quick shots. And Old Dominion hitting the offensive glass, getting opportunities, second and third opportunities.
They are really dominating the boards. Panichero into the corner, and it's a three for Eller.
Amber Eller high stepping it down on defense.
Amber Eller is a 16% long range shooter. She's only made six all year long. Holtzclaw got inside, fouled in the bucket.
Shamiqua Holtzclaw finally touching the ball. We saw in the Connecticut game that she had cramps. I don't know if it's a cramp or a knee, but she's trying to loosen things up. But it's a long time since Holtzclaw got the ball offensively.
She'll limp off the court. She has 16 points. She'll have a chance to add to that with a free throw.
Just kind of sneaking around baseline where she's so dangerous. And you kind of lose sight of her. Mashinguana too late recovering. And you really have to keep an eye on Holtzclaw. But what Tennessee has done well also is the fact that they've been able to get everybody involved. And now you lose sight of Holtzclaw again. You got to say, oh, let's wake up.
It's a great jump stop by her. And I go back to when we were talking this morning in our production meeting. And you were asked, how does she rank? And I think the question was this year as a player. And you said she's one of the greatest of all time already.
Well, the things that she does out on the floor, she is so blessed, Mike. I mean, her composure, her intensity. She hates to lose. She's very calm out there. But the magic that she has in that body is incredible. I mean, she runs the floor, the athleticism at 6'2". She handles the ball well. She is very good inside around the basket. She can rebound. We've seen the great defense that she plays. She loves to pass and get her teammates involved and also can shoot the outside shot. The two things probably, if you look at weaknesses in the game, which I'm sure by the time she's a senior, are her free throw shooting and maybe about her 15 to 18 foot shot.
2-point lead. Panichero throws it away. A little out of control that time. And I think they're going to get whole squad of the ball game right now and get Nia Butts back in here. We'll check it after the break. 6:42 to go. 49-49. Tennessee and Old Dominion. 6:42 to go for the national championship from Cincinnati. Here's the game summary from Riverfront Coliseum. ODU's field goal percentage creeping up to 41%. They were 32 at the half. Holdsclaw with 16 points, four below her average. Let's go to Nancy and check in while we have a moment.
I was in the Tennessee huddle getting an injury update. Jenny Moshak, the trainer, said that Abby Conklin's sprain will be okay at her left ankle. They re-taped her. It hurt initially, but she will be back in the game. Holdsclaw is getting some ice massage in her left thigh. Mike.
All right, thanks, Nancy. Tennessee basketball, 6.5 minutes remaining. ODU in the zone, trying to trap. Holdsclaw, tough pass. Butts in the lane. Butts has really come through in this game with 8.
Nia Butts, who does not get a lot of playing time, is not a great ball handler, mostly in for her defense, has been a big, big surprise and a nice surprise for the Lady Vols on the offensive end.
And the chair, tough shot, couldn't get the right spin on it, and it's out of bounds to Tennessee.
And the chair holding that right wrist. Trying to make something happen, slicing the defense. The one thing, Panichero is very good at getting into the free throw line and creating fouls, but here the defense just kind of lays back and forces Panichero to take that shot, and that's what you want to do against a player like that who likes to pass.
He's hit only 3 of 11 field goals tonight, normally near 45% in her field goal percentage. Holdsclaw past the Thompson. When the defense comes right at her, she finds the open man.
Nyree Robbins did a good job on Passion Thompson. She helped out on defense, and as soon as she left Thompson, she was wide open. And we talked about the passing of Shamika Holdsclaw.
Amber Eller, who hit that big shot just moments ago. Roberts, shot clock is at 9. Eller working on Jolly. Tough mismatch physically there for her.
Tennessee, if they can continue to control the backboards, it will take Old Dominion out of it.
But boy, when Old Dominion makes up their mind to send everybody in there, they are wicked. And Andrade is doing everything she can as a cheerleader after fouling out. Of course, they had foul troubles against Stanford in the one in overtime. But somehow, Tennessee maintained possession and got the bucket anyway. The lead back up to 6. They score 8 in a row.
Ella got her hand on that defensive lead. Old Dominion can't come up with it. As you said, the Lady Vols do and capitalize.
Thompson waiting for Monson Guan, that she's not going to go out after. Nice defensive scheme by Tennessee all night.
No question. They hit Monson Guan a high, and then when she's got to come down low, she makes a nice post move there. Passion Thompson got caught behind her that deep in the paint. Monson Guan will score.
Monson Guan has 14. She's got that beautiful little sweeping baby hook. Jolly against Eller. Holdsclaw with Panichero waiting for her. The freshman Butts makes the mistake. 3:58 left in a national championship game. Tennessee hanging on to a 4-point lead. And that could be a key down the stretch, Nancy. We're under 4 minutes to go. Tennessee has committed 5 team fouls, ODU 7. So it'll be the bonus for the Lady Vols from here on out. Monson Guan missed that one badly. Tennessee ball. Roberts had a hand on it, couldn't hold it. And ODU is going to go after every rebound from now on.
Well, they have to, because for Tennessee, their big players, Johnson and Thompson, only have 5 rebounds between them. And Old Dominion, if Roberts, Muchiwana, and Panacheri, who's not a big rebounder, but they are so aggressive, as you said, they go after everything.
3 minutes and 25 seconds to go for national championship. Time to find out who the players are. Nice penetration, but she threw it away, and fortunately for Tennessee, Panichero had a foot on the baseline and goes into the many photographers at the end of the baseline covering the tournament. Abby Conklin will come back in after they worked on that ankle, taking Johnson out of the ballgame, so they go a little smaller. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Normally, where you look for hold scores, you got Panichero on her. Got it off the screen.
Panichero twisting that ankle, as you said on those cameras down low, and she did not react to when the ball was put in play. Hold score went right by her.
18 for hold score, the lead up to 6. The steal by Conklin.
And there's Kelly Jolly sagging off Stacey Hines again.
25 turnovers for ODU.
When it looks like it's wide open, all of a sudden, Crush just goes right in the middle.
Backdoor holds court. Assist to Jolly. They can smell a second straight national title. Timeout, Old Dominion. Annie, it looked for all the world in the middle of the second half that ODU had grabbed all the momentum it would need, but somehow Tennessee has taken it back. See, on a 12-2 run, they have taken the lead 59-51, 2:35 to go with a national championship on the line, and the superstars step up when they have to.
And the great ones make it look so easy. Effortless. She just uses Panichero going to the basket. Very calm. Didn't use any energy. Nice and slow. And boom, she just explodes.
And credit to Kelly Jolly, who made the pass. Kelly Jolly did not play when these teams met earlier in the season, and ODU win. She has 10 assists tonight. That's huge, especially against this defensive pressure.
And that is a career high for her.
Every possession now huge for ODU. Blocked, guess who?
Good old number 23.
Pat Summitt, could it be a 5th national championship?
Well, people were talking to her about going for Dean Smith's record, but when you got a player like Shamiqua Holzclaw, why not go for John Wooden's record?
Machiwana, tough shot. She has 16. ODU needs defensive stops. Here comes the double team. Holzclaw, nice save, and she puts it in.
Assist, just very calm, seeing the double team, and seeing Holzclaw.
That one with a great outside touch. Are you kidding?
The Bomber again.
61-56. Evelyn has 10.
And you gotta go. This is the last minute 30 seconds. You gotta play defense.
Conklin finally gets it up to Elzy. And Elzy fouled by Machiwana. That'll be 3 on Machiwana, and we will shoot free throws, 1-1.
What I really like about this play that we're going to see is Kelly Jolly really sees Panichero coming from behind. Holzclaw way outside. She sees Kelly Jolly just hanging back. As we talked earlier, she really hides herself well. She'll stay way outside, and boom, she's all of a sudden she's down in the middle of the paint, and Kelly Jolly picked her up.
Check the foul on Machiwana. It is her 4th. Tennessee has not made a free throw tonight. They are 0-for-3 as a team. Elzy, the poorest free throw shooter among their starters at 57%. She will go to the line 1-1. Missed the front end.
And Old Dominion has to take care of business as far as off missed free throws. Take advantage of it.
And Elzy will be the player they go after when Tennessee gets the ball back. Cavill. Roberts. Passion Thompson will rebound. They got it to Elzy. They're going to try to foul her. Holzclaw, the second worst free throw shooter. Trying to keep the ball moving. There's no 10 seconds.
I was going to say, you got a foul. Can't keep wasting time.
You can spend all 30 seconds in the backcourt if you choose to. And that's what they're fighting for. The trophy, the prestige. And Annie, you know as well as anyone else, the memories that will last a lifetime.
There's no question. I was fortunate enough to play in 78 UCLA team that won it all. And not only the memories of the game, but the friendships that you develop, the players that you play with, and this Tennessee team. Being in the Final Four last year, winning the championship game. They were in the championship game 2 years ago against Connecticut when they won it all and going undefeated. And this is an experienced ball club, this Tennessee team. And watch out for the next couple years because they've got some dynamite freshmen coming in.
Holzclaw, clutch free throw. She has 24. Michelle Marcinet, the point guard from last year's national championship team. And here is a foul on Tiffany Johnson.
The last team to win back-to-back championships was back in 83 and 84, USC. Cheryl Miller and Carla and Pam McGee. Tremendous team, and Tennessee looks like they might do it.
That was only the sixth team foul on Tennessee, so it's a non-shooting foul. Panichero tries a three. The clear out by Johnson. Passion Thompson with a rebound, and she fouled. 50.5 to go.
Tiffany and Johnson and Passion Thompson have done a tremendous job on the offensive end and also playing great defense. You see Tiffany Johnson with the big block against Machiguana, who goes up at 6'5", and Tiffany Johnson just knocks it out of there. They've come up with some big defensive plays and have made ODU work very hard on the inside. The big players for Old Dominion have struggled as far as getting the ball in their hands where they want it.
Passion Thompson missed two free throws earlier in the game. She is a very good free throw shooter at 77.7%. And now is the time when you need to hit them to ice the game. They're up by seven.
Passion Thompson and Abby Conklin, the only two seniors on this team. And you see her mom taking a part of history in those pictures.
Her mom, Ruby Jean, doesn't want a picture of that one as she misses the front end of a one-on-one. That's two for Tennessee in the closing minutes.
You got to shoot the three somewhere.
This is Ebron, the player they want to take it, and she is fouled. Silly foul by Kelly Jolly.
But Kelly Jolly, the second time that she has fouled Ebron, said, "Hey, I am not doing it." If you watch Evelyn's follow-through, she just almost grabs the defensive player right into you, and it's a great move.
Evelyn will shoot three. She is their best free throw shooter, as pure as you'll ever see.
And watch the follow-through. See how she jackknives right into the defensive player? Jolly's up on her and makes the contact, but Evelyn helps create that with that jackknife.
That's something you have to see as a player and get the heck out of it. And Evelyn misses a free throw.
These two teams met for the championship back in 1980 when Old Dominion won it all, and then all of a sudden ODU and back in 85 also win a championship. But it looks like it's going to be Tennessee's year. And nobody thought they'd be here. With 10 losses, they thought that this was Pat Summitt's down year and everybody else would have a chance to sneak in on the Lady Vols.
ODU with only one more chance to stop the clock, and Evelyn, who was an 84.8% free throw shooter, has missed the first two. A lot of pressure on the sophomore from Williamsport, Ohio. She can make it a 6-point game with this one. And ODU will get Natalie Diaz, the freshman from Mojave Valley, Arizona, back in the ball game. Evelyn will come out, offensive, defensive substitution.
I tell you, this defense, they come up with some steals, some big buckets, they gotta stop the clock.
Conklin was fouled. They like to have the ball in her hands because she's an 83.6% free throw shooter.
Well, Abby Conklin said this year, she was asked, well, where would you be if you didn't have Shamequa Holzkla? Spring break.
Absolutely. You can't take someone. We have seen the skills that she has displayed in this tournament, and normally you don't expect a big scorer to be that much of a defensive force, but they have sicked her on some big-time players, and she's come through. There's the free throw story so far. Tennessee is really hurting itself right now, but still up by six.
And this has been a fun game to watch because there have not been a lot of free throws in this game.
I think on the whole, a very well-officiated ball game.
No question.
1-1 for Conklin. Big shot. 11 points for Abby Conklin off the bench. And you have to credit this senior for telling her coach, Pat Summitt, I'd help you more coming off the bench. She had a chance to be in the starting lineup for a national championship.
Yeah, but she's in at the end of the game. That's
it's not who starts it, who finishes. 65-57 Tennessee. And Pat Summitt will call a timeout. She doesn't necessarily want to stop the clock, but she wants to talk to her club about what she wants defensively, in particular, down the stretch here. Of course, there is a history of back-to-back titles in women's basketball. When it was the AIAW, the two teams that really got it started, Immaculata and Delta State, each won three in a row, and then Old Dominion in 79 and 80.
Kathy Rush, the coach at Immaculata, Delta State, the great Margaret Wade, Old Dominion, Marianne Stanley was there, and then the last one, we see.
An excellent point made by a writer who was talking about Old Dominion and said they are being pushed out as an independent school, as a small-time school, by some of the big conferences now. We saw seven SEC teams get in the NCAA tournament. And you knew that going to Europe was a quick fix thing for them, and it got them back to the championship game.
They played in the Colonial Athletic Association, where Wendy Leary has been the three-time coach of the year, and they went 16-0, and they haven't gotten a lot of credit there, and a lot of people have felt that that is a soft league. But Old Dominion has always been in the top 20, top 25 year after year, so you can't take anything away from that as far as what Wendy Leary has done there, and also Marianne Stanley before that. But yes, it can be a quick fix, but she's got some good recruits coming in. Don't count them out next year.
And certainly restored the pride in this program as they have fought their way into a national championship game. They come in tonight 34-1 with 33 straight victories on the season. What they have run into is a Tennessee team that everybody wrote off in the middle of the year as they had lost 10 games and figured this simply would not be Pat Summitt's year. But Pat Summitt and her team had other ideas.
And the team has really peaked going into this tournament. It's like winter, spring, summer, fall. Postseason is the best season of all for Pat Summitt.
Panichero, nice drive, gets the bucket. They'll stop the clock with 32 seconds to go.
I have to give credit to Debbie Ayers, who was an assistant for Pat, for saying that. She faxed that to Pat going into this tournament.
Of course, one of the reasons Tennessee has played so well down the stretch, they got Kelly Jolly back, who had been out injured, and she has been the key to running their offense at point guard, especially when they lost Lori Milligan, who was subbing for her.
No question about it. Also, Kyra Elzey in the backcourt. The big question, you see Kelly Jolly along with Passion Thompson, was the backcourt graduating Latina Davis and Michelle Marciniak? That was a big question. Kelly Jolly and Lori Milligan were going to be the starting backcourt for this Lady Vol team. Kelly Jolly with the ACL injury. There you see Michelle Marciniak rooting her Lady Vols on. But Kelly Jolly, with her heart and soul and determination to work back through those injuries off the ACL and the ankle, has led this team.
When you really think about tonight's matchup, it's remarkable because there are three All-Americans on the court. You've got Matchinguana and Panichero and the brilliant Shamequa Holzkla. Here is what they have done. Holzkla over her average in points. Panichero has had a tough night, but she's had an outstanding second half. Six assists in the second half. Matchinguana, she averages 20 points a game and 7.5 rebounds, so she is close But they are running out of time now with 32 seconds left.
Tennessee has really made it difficult for Mashinguana and Roberts to get the kind of shots they like in the paint area.
Most of the Tennessee team will be made up of their best free throw shooters. Holtzclaw is out there only 67%, but she is clutch. They move the ball to avoid the foul ahead of the pack. Holtzclaw missed the ball. But they're not going to be too upset because the clock runs. Looking at Holtzclaw, she might have done that on purpose. A three is missed. Tennessee with a rebound, 13.4 seconds to go.
No, I don't think she was that smart on that play to miss it. She's just going, how did I miss it? She's laughing. And
she's laughing too hard.
But give credit to the 5'8", Amber Eller, hustling down. She just really worked hard to get back down court. You see Chimiko Holtzclaw released down court. Abby Conklin looking down, having enough sense to see the open floor with Holtzclaw. Holtzclaw just a little hard, said, oh, no! And she can afford to do that with the kind of lead that Old Dominion has with this much time.
Up by six with 13-4 left. You can laugh at a mistake.
No matter how good you are, the mistakes can always be there.
Misty Green with a free throw, her first point of the night. That makes it a three-possession game and may have done it.
And I think Pat Summitt's just shaking her head in disbelief that they did it again.
Offensive rebound to Johnson. And Tennessee has called a timeout with 10.3 seconds to go. And I'm not sure that any of the Tennessee players know who called timeout.
Well, Pat Summitt's saying, no, that's okay. We'll get Kyra Elzy in anyways.
Pat Summitt, just an incredible record. 81.4% of her games have been wins. Rivaling the Dean Smith kind of record with 21 straight seasons with 20 or more wins. This is her 10th Final Four, her 7th title game. This is going to be her 5th NCAA title, the 5th in 11 years. That's remarkable.
And she has beaten Adolph Rupp, who has 4. John Wooden, she's halfway there. John Wooden was 10 championships out of 12, and that's the record she's going after now. She said if she coaches at least another 10 years, well, let's see. She can get 5 out of that, easy.
Even more remarkable, this is the most losses ever for a team in a title game. Tennessee is only, and I say only because there are some really gaudy records out there, like ODU 34-1. Tennessee comes in tonight only 28-10.
And this is the 10th year anniversary of their very first championship back in 87 when they had 9 losses.
And they broke their own record. That was the previous record.
But give credit to this team, Mary Andrade, the Old Dominion team worked so hard to get here to this championship game.
They have had a remarkable season, but they only have 10 seconds left, it would appear, in the 96-97 campaign and will finish second to Tennessee. Jolly fouled. Diaz hustling right down to the wire.
All year long, this Old Dominion team has played such great defense against their opponents. And tonight, coming out from the start, it was Tennessee that put the pressure on Old Dominion.
Terrible break for Andrade. She fouled out of the ball game earlier. They really count on her emotional leadership, her defense, and without her, it really took a weapon away from Wendy Larry. Johnny hits the first, she'll get another. 67-59, Tennessee.
Kelly Jolly, a career high, 11 assists, and boy, were those some pretty passes.
She had some huge plays in the second half. Tennessee now clearing the bench. Holtzclaw gets a standing ovation from the Lady Vol faithful, and boy, does she deserve it. Holtzclaw with 24 points in the national championship game, and these kids really did a great job.
And there's the grandmother. And Passion Thompson and Abby Conklin, the two seniors, having 2 NCAA championships. Boy, were they a big part in bringing it home.
For Jolly. Otero lost the ball out of bounds as she tried to give it off to Amber Eller. The 26th turnover for ODU. And Shamiqua Holdsclaw, 7 boards, 24 points, 55% from the floor. And that is our player of the game and maybe the national player of the year in the next two seasons. And the emotion starting to spill over for ODU as they have played so well and fought so hard, only to come up short in the national championship game.
Laurie Milligan making an appearance, the junior.
That right knee heavily wrapped. She had surgery only 6 weeks ago, and she will inbound the basketball. Nice gesture on behalf of Tennessee to get it in the game, and they've done it. Back-to-back championship. From Tennessee. They beat them earlier in the year and went down fighting here in the national championship game. But Shamiqua Holdsclaw and the Lady Vols were too much in an unexpected turnaround when they fell out of the top 10 in mid-year. Most of us wrote them off. They didn't. And they fought back to win it all. 68-59. And for Pat Summitt, her fifth national championship in 11 years.